I love that Mori, even in Hollow House, just has her scythe still. I guess it'd be more work to technically, like, make a new set of sprites without it, but it's just so funny. Hey guys, what's going on? This is Will here. Today, we are going to be having a very straightforward sort of character showcase for Calliope Mori, not counting the initial video on this channel I've done. Some people count that as a Gura showcase, but it really wasn't. This is basically the last myth character that we have to show off in some way, and don't worry, a proper Gura showcase in the future would be coming, theoretically. However, I have now said Gura's name more times than I've said Mori's name in this, or, you know, throughout the rest of the video, I will probably bounce between calling her Mori and Calli. But that said, we're going to look at Calli's kit. I like that because it alliterates. Calli's starting weapon is the Scythe Swing. Her special attack is called the Reaper, and she has three unique skills: the Rapper, Death, and Workaholic. Looking at Calli's base stats, her HP is at 70, which is, it's all right. Her attack scaling is 1.15 times, which, if I'm remembering correctly, is actually a buff on top of what she had before. I believe prior to 0.6, she had 1.1, but they buffed her up a little bit more. Her speed scaling is at 1.3, which is okay. There's been a lot of speedy characters that have come out in future updates after the base release of the game. Speed is just a very competitive tier. Her crit rate is the max 10% currently possible in the game, which is awesome, especially as we get into her kit. You'll see why that's so great. And her bounce ball size is 4 out of 5. I have to admit, and many would agree, that's pretty big. Her normal attack being the Scythe Swing, it is very straightforward, in the exact way you would expect the Grim Reaper, Death itself, to swing a scythe in a hacking motion, preferably somewhere approaching a 180 degree arc. That's exactly how this attack works. It gets a few level up bonuses, mostly in terms of increases in damage, but there is a couple instances of attack area increasing. There's one instance of reducing the time between attacks. And level 7, as always, is the really big push up in damage. And the Awakened Scythe actually has a 10% chance to instant KO. That might sound kind of nuts, but again, we'll look at her actual kit. You'll see this is actually playing into some synergies. Looking at her awakened weapon, it actually has really, really good scaling on it. 28 to 34 base damage, which is about 300% scaling. And of course, just to summarize some of the little detailed notes on the wiki, just to lay the groundwork for what KOing instantly means at level 7, it means that there is a percent chance that a foe will be defeated regardless of their remaining HP after being hit by the attack. This effect cannot work on boss targets. Calli's special attack is called the Reaper. It goes on a cooldown of 80 seconds, and her special is just a really, really good buff. So basically, instead of your crits doing double damage, they do triple damage. You get increased scythe damage, which is your main attack damage, also by 300%, and this lasts for 15 seconds. So as you can see, this is the myth character with the longest cooldown on her special, but because of the uptime of her 15-second buff, and since the special is only a buff, your cooldown is effectively more like 65 seconds. Calli's first skill is the Rapper, and it is a very straightforward skill. Targets within 100, 125, or 150 pixels will take an iterative 10, 15, or 20% damage. So get enemies real close to you, and all of your attacks will start doing more damage. The twist is that at level 3, you will also gain an additional 10% chance to critically hit. Her second skill is simply called Death. When defeating an opponent with Scythe Swing or Death, so this is a skill that procs itself, there is an iterative 20, 25, or 30% chance to create an explosion. This explosion will deal an iterative 60, 90, or 120% damage with a 5, 8, or 10% chance to KO. So here's another mention of that chance to KO. Now, a thing to keep in mind is what activates this skill. So you need to be hitting things with your main weapon, your scythe, or something needs to be KO'd as a result of the death ability itself. Because the death ability, when defeating a target, is creating an explosion that deals splash damage. The difference is that that splash damage is basically taking on some of the properties of your main scythe weapon and having a chance to instant KO. What this means is that death can actually cause a chain reaction of activating multiple times off of one attack. Because if you swing your scythe, you defeat a target, you activate the percent chance to create an explosion, and either that explosion defeats another target, or that explosion procs that KO chance, it could have a chance of proccing death again. You're going to be KOing thousands of enemies per round, or if you're going endless, it can go really even into the mid-thousands. You are definitely going to be chain reacting and activating death very, very often. Her third skill is Workaholic. For each target defeated, you can increase your attack by an iterated 2, 3, or 4% for 4 seconds, and that ceiling will iterate from 40 to 60 to 80%. So we divide all of these things as needed, right? 40 into 2, 60 into 3, or 80 into 4. As you can see, this is actually a skill that stacks. You have 20 stacks that you accumulate to give yourself an attack buff. Very similar to the wrapper, with Workaholic, there is an extra effect you get at level 3, where your speed will actually increase by 2% up to 40. So once you hit level 3 with Workaholic, it's an attack and speed buff. And of course, at all levels, this refreshes your duration for each target defeated. So even though you gain those isolated attack and speed increases for 4 seconds, as long as you're just defeating an enemy every 4 seconds, that cooldown keeps resetting back to the maximum 4. So you just gotta keep chaining it. Which again, everything kind of happens automatically in this game. You don't really activate your attacks, they just happen, so it's kind of hard to not have Workaholic up at max at almost all times. To keep the long story very short, obviously what we are looking at here with Calli is a very straightforward, by-the-numbers crit character. Everything is about KOs, it's about critical hits, it's about dealing lots of damage, it's about instant kills. This is very appropriate for, you know, death, or at least a merchant of death. You're just trying to deal the big damage or have the KO symbol pop up, and you're making all the enemies get sent to hell, basically. And such a strategy has some pretty straightforward item recommendations. First recommendation is very easy. Obviously, you're going to take Sake on Calli. We covered this in the tier list, but Sake is a very good strategic weapon to take on certain characters because it's a very balanced and approachable way to give yourself a crit buff, and it's a very manageable crit buff to also maintain. At level 3, we're going to be gaining 20% base crit at all times, as long as we're not taking damage, but when we eat food, we're getting even more crit. More often than not, we'll probably just be at the 20%, but since Calli is already a 10% base crit character, just taking into account base crit and Sake at level 3, that's 30% crit, which is really, really good. Second, I'm going to recommend the headphones. This is a very straightforward pick, at least in my opinion. Obviously, we're getting that 35% chance to negate a hit, and you push back with a shockwave when you do that. And the only reason I really want this on Calli is just because her main attack is that kind of just like a semicircle slash of a scythe. She's not really getting a dependable radial on her, right? So it can be a little difficult to watch your six when you're playing as Calli. So it's just nice to have that little bit of insurance to cover your back in case you're not really getting to it in time, or if you're getting surrounded, right? It at least kind of gives you a little bit of defense as you're being surrounded. And the third item, I think I want to try experimenting with it, so I'm really hoping that I get it in this run, but I want the Hope Soda. So this will increase the seconds on our cooldown for our special, but it will actually give us increased critical hit damage. Now this is really important in my opinion, because Calli is already very focused on big damage, and you're going to be scoring a lot of crits with her good crit rate. So a critical hit damage buff is essentially just a damage buff. It's also making her special activate a lot less. So I'm almost anticipating that there might be a very slight drop in overall DPS if you do it this way. I just want to see how high the numbers get. We're going to be getting a damage buff on our scythe, as well as just a new multiplier basically on our crits on top of what Hope Soda is already giving us. Our crits are going to be enormous. And I just want to see the big numbers because monkey brain. My weapon recommendation is Spider Cooking. Now, for me personally, it was really close between Spider Cooking and the axe. And the only reason is because Spider Cooking gives you a really dependable radial around you, so you're constantly damaging targets. It also provides a slow, which is kind of nice for someone with a melee weapon. And if you ever ran into a situation where you wanted to capitalize more on melee damage bonuses, Spider Cooking is a melee type item. Axe also has its upsides. I think its collab into the Crescent Bardiche is much better on Calli because it's also giving you elevated crits, but it also is the same hit arc basically as your scythe. So it feels really redundant, even though I'm sure that would also be really fun to watch the crit numbers. But I'm also trying to strike somewhat of a balance here between some versatility, and I think at all stages of any round, spider cooking is probably going to take you further than the axe, unless you were going for something like BL Fujoshi, which is the collab between the BL book and the axe. But again, that's a very narrow use case. It's pretty easy to get. But again, I'm talking in theoretics here. I think more evenly spread across the board, spider cooking is probably just going to be more useful for you in more situations. And for my stamp recommendation, it's pretty easy to just recommend the attack up stamp. I mean, again, Calli is just all damage all the time. She's all crits all the time. She's all instant KOs all the time. Why would we not try to go for a stamp that's pretty common to find? Increases your weapon damage by the full 25% at level 3, then also gives you a crit damage percent buff. There is absolutely no downside to taking this item on basically any character, but especially when you're talking about someone like Calli who's benefiting off of attack buffs and benefiting off of things like elevated crits. This is an absolute no-brainer. This is just full damage build. And full damage build is exactly what describes Calli. She is a very straightforward character. I don't think she teaches quite as many good habits, which is why I didn't really recommend her in that same regard as I did someone like Kiara. I think Kiara has a much more balanced kit, whereas I think Calli, because she's so focused on things like just damage and instant kills, I think she has a tendency to teach to be overly aggressive and to try to build every character this way. When really this is not the way you should probably be building characters. Again, this is a survival game. But all that being said, it doesn't mean that Calli's not really fun to play as, because this is still a blast to see how big the numbers get. Speaking of which, I just want to get right into it. I'm going to go right to the stage from here. Let's see how Calli goes. All right, guys, let's do this. We need to go right for... Oh my god, that's already so tempting. The ninja headband is probably not even going to be that good, but just the melee weapon bonus. We'll keep an eye on our skills for now. So as you can see, we've got our little measurement around us, right? So this is for the wrapper, right? We get the damage buff as long as we're hitting people within this little circle. And as you can see, with how small the circle is right now, you could see that if we got some like size buffs to our actual scythe with something like Nightly Milk, you could see how the scythe could actually get outside of this circle potentially, right? So it's, again, it's one of those situations where early on Nightly Milk is maybe not optimal on Calli specifically, but the problem is that, you know, with every level of the wrapper you get, it gets to be a wider circle. So it eventually gets so big that your melee weapon doesn't really, it doesn't really leave it anymore. There's not a whole lot of panache you really gotta demonstrate, but it is cool. We just saw that cool little AoE happening right there. We got a whole AoE of just like instant KOs right there from death, which was really, really cool. And that's just what's kind of fun about Calli. You know, her weapon starts out a little on the slow side. Even at like max awakened, it's like kind of slow-ish, but you're even seeing like we don't even really have any like fancy sort of buffs going on really. Nothing that Calli isn't just, you know, naturally doing on her own, right? And we're already hitting like 40s, right? When our crits hit. I mean, what are we hitting? Like 60s, I think? There's our 60s and 70s. I was like, where are these? I might have just been misreading the numbers in a rush. I'm trying to get over to these anvils, but this giant squirrel keeps getting in the way, and it's annoying me. Let's get these level 4 scythe. Look, I have so many things I'm trying to get here. Let's get the wrapper maxed. Yeah, see, so there's level 3 the wrapper, right? You're probably not getting... I mean, maybe if you had full level 3 Nightly Milk, maybe your scythe would be going a little bit outside of that. We're also getting a triple. A triple with two anvils. We're setting ourselves up pretty well. Well, I mean, Calli can use that pretty well. Let's go with the bounce ball. I'll take the scythe swing. Crit damage enchantment on the idol song, so I might even take that too. Just again, I mean, why not? We're doing crits and stuff, right? Why wouldn't we? And again, at level 7, now that we have the Awakened Scythe, that's another 40% damage on the overall scaling. So, again, we'll take this Lifesteal Stamp. Obviously no downside in taking it. But, I mean, look at that. 120 damage on the crits. 130. Like, if you just want to scale up your damage really quickly, like, Calli doesn't have the highest ceiling for damage and overall scaling in this game, not by a long shot. But her and Suisei are like the quickest to reach their ceiling, basically, or well, close to their ceiling, right? They just have such a quick, exponential glow up. Again, it's not the best or anything, right? I'm not going to sit here and try to tell someone that, like, it's the best kit. It's not. You can even look at the statistics in most cases and most comparisons. Calli's not the best in most ways, but it is very satisfying and fun. And ultimately, that's what matters. I mean, the idol song is actually kind of doing something, I guess, right? Because we're swinging 180. So if we focus on swinging left and right, we technically have coverage, like, kind of in the blind spots where our scythe doesn't. So that's, like, kind of cool. There's our attack up stamp, though. I'm being very reckless, and I just want to, like, max out my attack up stamp. So normally I probably wouldn't move out the HP steel stamp for that, but I just want to get... Dude, number one... See? Sake. Number one objective right now. Big number, right? Big scythe go burr. That's what this all is. We're almost dealing 200 damage crits right now. We need Hope Soda, guys. So there's our level 3 sake. What is this? What is this luck? This is another triple. Holy moly. They're making up for all the times they screwed me in the last couple videos. I'll take that. I'll take that. And, sure. Stolen piggy bank. Why not? We're a little faster, at least. Right? We can make up for that lost pickup range because we just move faster, so... We can swoop in closer to things, take more risks, pick up stuff anyway. There we go. We just broke 200 right there, I think. I think we just broke 200. Oh, we did. I saw 201. Love it. Look at these big numbers, dude. All right, guys. Next boss that comes out, we're demonstrating the special, I think. I think that's the way to go. I think that's the way to go, and I think that's him right there. All right. Here's our big buff. Look at these crits. Look at these crits. Look at these crits. It's so good. Spider cooking. Look at those. Holy moly. See how huge? Look, 1,000. We just hit 1,000, guys. Isn't that something? I mean, I'm almost tempted to just take the crit up. You know what I mean? I'm almost tempted. I won't go too nuts. But dude, the numbers, right? Like the way that when you hit 1,000 plus on your damage, like the number indicator like doubles in size. Very fun. And that's why I want the Hope Soda now, because I want that number to get even bigger. Maybe I can try to do some rerolls and see if we can get something with the Hope Soda, because that would be super fun. Well, there's the headphones too, though. I did say headphones was recommended, so we might have to go for it. All I can really do is talk myself in circles about how fun Calli's kit is, because it's just big number. It's just big number, the kit. That's all it does. And KOs. You can count how many instant KOs you get too, I guess. Guys, that is 3 triples. What is happening? Did someone mess with my game? Did someone... What happened here? I can level up all this stuff, though. Every time I level up now, I'm getting a result of something I should be leveling up. There's some size up stamp. Maybe we can also size up the the scythe to go larger than the AoE again and just screw over our entire kit. Oh, it is. There's already a bit of it that's outside the circle now because of the size up stamp. See, this is what's fun about Calli. It's fun just to mess around because you're already just dealing so much damage, right? Like, Calli, I think she can be a challenging one to take into the higher content. They're all doable, of course, obviously, right? All content is doable with all characters. But Calli, compared to the others, is definitely one of the more unfortunate ones, right? Like the little bit worse off than some of the others. But it's just so fun to mess around and like low to mid content with her, because you just really want to see the numbers, man. How red can you make the crits, right? Minmaxers, you understand. It's just fun to mess with. All right, there's the maxed out. Oh, there's the Hope Soda, guys. We got the Hope Soda. We got the whole kit. We got the whole kit that I was talking about. We got the whole build. I got all the recommended stuff. I think that's also the first time in this series, I think, that I've gotten everything, right? We got our 3 items. We got the weapon I recommended, and we got the stamp. That's incredible. How cool is that? But I don't want to use my special yet. But I'm running out of time. I don't think I'll max out Hope Soda before I get a chance to. Okay, let's get rid of the Psycho Axe. Let's see if we can get more Hope Soda. Okay, there's Hope Soda. Okay, that's a glow stick, unfortunately. I want the biggest damage I can possibly do, though. But I'm running... I definitely have to do it once we're hitting, like, 200 enemies or something. I'll have no choice. But I might max out the Hope Soda, guys. Let's see if we can do it. I want the biggest numbers. We're hitting, like, orange crits now. Like, on the regular. That's very, very exciting. Here we go. All right. And there's a boss, so I think this is probably the time, guys. Let's just grab this. Grab some gravitied XP. There we go. All right. Let's do it. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What is that? 1,700? 1,200? Oh, my goodness. Oh, my God. Well, I mean, we definitely just made that boss disappear. That is, without a doubt, that was bound to happen. Oh, yeah, dude. Look at this. Everyone is just getting wiped off the map every time I swing under that. Those were so high up. Those crits were enormous. I loved it. I mean, again, that's not even anywhere close to how high you could theoretically get it with Calli. It, obviously, her ceiling gets a little higher than that. I mean, we're doing like usually 8 to 10 minute content in the time mode, right? So you're not going to hit like the very top of where she can go. But just again, compared to like what other characters we're usually playing as kind of get to, you know what I mean? Like, it's more about that perspective, right? We're easily hitting... I mean, when we were under our super, we were dealing, like, 5 to 10 times what other characters in this same sort of metric are doing, right? So, and then there's even a crit up stamp that we just picked up at the end, because this game just loved me in this one round, I guess. That was playing as Calli. As you can see, there's, like, some give and take with her whole kit, right? So we were dealing really, really consistent damage. As you can see, as we got into the last like third of this round, we were consistently nowhere near full health. It demonstrates exactly what her kit is, which is all buff, all KO, no defense. There is absolutely no fortification in her kit anywhere. There's not even CC. There's not even pushback, really. Calli's whole shtick is the best defense is a good offense. I can't get hit if you're already dead. Can we also just say that Calli's like drippy costume is like the coolest shit ever? That is like freaking awesome, right? Is that not fantastic? Can we also just say, like, again, related but kind of not related at the same time, really not a fan of like a lot of like J-pop and K-pop groups, right? So I didn't know about this one K-pop song until I started seeing like AI covers of it, right? The whole like AI song meme started happening a few months ago. And it's this song by 5050 called Cupid. Never knew the song before, listened to the original, and I was like, wow, yeah, this is that same bubblegummy pop garbage that I don't like. I won't like it. And then I started hearing like an AI cover of like Gura doing it. And I was like, she did an alright job, AI Gura, but I still hate this song. And then I listened to the real Gura do it, because she did it in like a karaoke stream, right? And I listened to it, and I thought, wow, I still don't like this song. It was the same impression. I was like, wow, real Gura totally showed up AI Gura. Still hate this song. Do you want to know whose cover of this song made me actually enjoy it? Calli's. Man, that she did such an incredible cover of that song. She took a song I didn't like, that a VTuber I watch more regularly covered and I still didn't like, and made it into a song that I liked. She like put this like lo-fi, like easy listening sort of spin on it. It's so good. Look, if you've not watched Calliope Mori's cover of Cupid by 5050, you gotta look it up. It's really nice. Anyway, I just went on a big tangent about music, but I guess it kind of makes sense because she's a gamer TM, guys, don't get me wrong. But, you know, she's got a music career, right? So, very, very cool kit. She is a spear and a shield at the same time because the way that she protects herself is by unaliving everything that's in front of her that poses any threat. Very fun to get crits. You saw the size of the crits, right? Again, you got to take this all in a bubble, right? When we're playing other characters in this 10-minute sort of format, it puts into perspective when what we consider to be pretty strong and, like, capable characters kind of starting to deal, you know, usually between 80 and 120, right, by the time we're kind of reaching the end, right? And then lower sort of damage characters that might have other strengths elsewhere are usually dealing maybe 60 to approaching 80, right? Calli was regularly dealing 200 by, like, halfway through the round, and then when her special was up, was hitting 1,000 and then like 12 to 1700 by the end. The damage ceiling has been raised to a point that will probably not be surpassed in the rest of these showcases, because Calli has the very unique strength of peaking in damage the earliest of probably every single character in this game. Does she peak the highest? Nope, not even close. Does she peak the earliest and fastest? 100% yes. So if you're the kind of person that wants to get up to your max very, very quickly and then try to ride out that wave with an early start, you definitely have to pick up Mori. Or if you're a crit whore. If you're a crit whore, if you come from things like Borderlands and Warframe and you just want to see big number go burr, 100% you play Calli. Thank you so much for watching today. Let me know what you guys think of Calliope Mori, the VTuber or the character in the game. Please let me know down below. Let me know also down below if you guys want to see any other characters be showcased. I always love hearing about what direction someone might want me to get poked in. Be sure to subscribe if you liked what you saw. I do lots of gaming content as well as HoloCure content, as you can see. Like the video if you liked it, guys. Follow me on Rumble and Odysee if those are places you frequent. But most of all, I just hope you guys are enjoying your weekend. I apologize that this video came out about a day late. Friday was very busy for me, and that was supposed to be publishing date. But basically, because I got busy, I didn't have a chance to actually, like, meta tag the video before end of the day. So you're basically getting it on Saturday instead. But most of all, I hope the upcoming week, once you've had some time to rest up, we'll treat you all very well. Take care, and we'll talk soon. Oh, it's almost time for Mori's stream. Look at her go.